Good evening. Tonight, let's talk about five element theory. Thousands of years ago, people lived in a very interactive way with nature, more so than today, and they used to observe and understand nature and its elements and their bodies, and they used it to heal illnesses and just have a better understanding of how the world works around them and with them. So this Chinese tradition views the world as being made up out of five elements: fire, earth, metal, water, and wood. And each one of them has its own personality, its own life cycle, season, its own color, its own climate, and so forth. And just like everything in balance, one element controls the next one, and also one element creates the next one. So let me just show you. And this is where the theory of creation cycle and control cycle comes from. So creation cycle, right here. Fire creates earth by giving it warmth, giving it a fire through its core, and creating ashes, which create soil. Earth creates metal by giving it its abundant minerals. Metal creates water by giving it its life-sustaining minerals. Water gives growth to wood, so creates wood by giving it growth. And wood grows fire by fueling it. It's quite simple to understand in this case. So you can see that one cannot survive without the other. There's also a control cycle. And control cycle controls the next one. So fire controls metal by melting it. Metal controls wood by cutting it. Wood controls earth by holding it in place with its roots. And then earth creates water by absorbing it and sustaining it. And water extinguishes the fire. So therefore, there's always two sides to everything. And just as these elements appear in our environment, they also are part of each individual you. And we all have personalities that come with all of these elements. However, one usually rises above as the most prominent, and it gives you your personality type: fire, earth, metal, water, or wood. So in each of these videos, I'm going to talk about one at a time, okay? And just knowing and understanding your personality type can give you a lot of power to learn how to work with instead of against your weaknesses, your strengths. Also helps you understand how you can interact with people better, especially people of different personality types, so you can understand yourself and them better. Okay? So let's move on to today's sign and element. personality, your colors are red for yang or masculine energy, and purple for yin or feminine energy. Your air archetype is a wizard. Season is summer. Summer. And as a wizard, you are enchanting. You feed your senses by appreciating and absorbing every nuance of every sight, smell, taste, touch, and so forth. How about we start creating fire of these long matches? As a fire personality, people are drawn to you. You are bright, exciting. Entertaining. Motivating person. Just like fire, fire personalities can be warm, welcoming, loving, but also can burn. They always need others. Keep them burning, so to say. Some of the traits include passion, need to create, love, leadership, motivation, but also fire can be aggressive and possessive. It can very easily be jealous. It needs others to keep it going, so it can be attention seeking. People love to bask in the presence of fire. Feed off of its energy. It's intoxicating. So in Chinese medicine, fire represents heart, heart and small intestine. Therefore, people of this personality can have possible heart problems and digestive problems too. So that's something to remember. Oh, that sounds so good. As far as appearance goes, oftentimes fire personalities have very warm hands, have a tendency to sweat a lot, also often very slim, as they burn off a lot of calories. I guess the most important thing to remember is that fire personalities are strong, persistent, but also they can spread and wander very easily. Some Palo Santo's wood. Fire is intoxicating, invigorating. You always want to come closer to it. Little bit of its warmth. Take it with you. Fire represents passion, motivation, creation. Creates the core of our earth, warms all of us, feeds the volcanoes, gives us our food, and of course it keeps us warm. As soon as fire or candle is introduced into the atmosphere, everything changes. Your mood changes. You feel much more soothed and comforted. it's a feeling of snugginess and just comfort and warmth. Of course, the little fluttering, flickering sound of the candle. So pleasant, so gentle. Thank you very much for being here and joining me on this little firecracker of a video. Sound. Little, we used to sit by the bonfire, sing songs.